You should be most welcome to Jimmerism Total Nerdery channel. Today I will review my mouse, the Corsair Scimitar Pro RGB. I've been using it for more than 2 years, so it's high time to do a proper review of it. So here we have it, my Corsair Scimitar Pro RGB. After 2 years of use. And you can see that it still looks completely fine, and well, I will say some good things and some bad things about this. Right, one thing is that it's been holding up, it's fine to use, it's still about as good as when I got it. I haven't broken anything on it, and well, I think the quality seems to be pretty decent. Now, I have pretty large hands, and this mouse is for large, like-handed people, but I also feel it's a little bit too small for me sometimes, because I want support in the middle of my palm like this, and I put it here, and if I do that, it kind of, my finger kind of sticks over this little bottom here. So if you have super small hands or super large hands, I don't think I have super large hands, but I have pretty large hands, I think. So if you have that, this mouse might feel a little bit unergonomical. I think it's decently ergonomical indeed. I just need to have a very exact grip. I'll need to have it slightly tilted like this, and I can kind of get the palm support while just exactly, just not really going over the limit here. So it's a little bit difficult. It is decently nice to use, but the friction of it is like very low when you slide around here. But your little finger may get in the way and actually just get into the map, and you almost kind of pinch it when you slide it like this. So you have to kind of lift up your little finger, and it's a little bit hard to... It feels like you don't really know where you should put all your fingers on this thing. It's a lot of buttons for the thumb, so you have a lot to do here, but not so much to do here. It would actually be interesting to have some, you know, some mouse with this many buttons that actually has button for all the four fingers here, you know, because you have space for them. You don't need to like do like this. You could like fit it all here actually. Well, anyways. That's like the buttons here. It feels pretty nice to click. I like the clicking sound and clicking feeling of this this mouse. It's one of the better I've felt. The thumb buttons are not as nice to click on, but they are good enough. And now I do a lot of weird commands here because I have set them all up to do stuff. And I must say that while IQ absolutely sucks, setting up commands to do exactly what you want, you have like 12 buttons here, it's very useful. Like I've set up specific commands for when I edit video, so I use kind of all these 6 button pretty much a lot when I like edit, and it just speeds up the process a lot, and it's really nice. Thing is, however, that I've been playing lots of, like, strategy games, FPS games, and, you know, editing videos and stuff like that. And this mouse is best for editing video, unfortunately. Like, FPS games, I would not recommend anyone to use this when playing FPS games. Because when you're kind of, like, excited, it's easy to click a lot of buttons at the same time. And then you will definitely click something like bad. It's not very good when you accidentally rrk, and you make do weird stuff. Like I recorded a Battlefield 2 video a while ago where I accidentally stopped and started recording all the time because I forgot that for my Battlefield 2 program I set this button here to stop and start the recording. Well, so the mouse is good to use, and it's so many buttons though, so it takes a lot of time to set up those like macros and programs you want to have. And if you don't want to spend time on it, you should probably not have this mouse. But if you may indeed spend time on that and are okay with using IQ, got some tutorials on that, by the way, if you are struggling, because I sure did when I started, well, then it might be a really good mouse, because you can set up this like command here. It is a good quality mouse. But if you play FPS games, it's hard to use. And these buttons here for like changing the speed and the changing the speed and the program, they're mostly like getting in the way when you accidentally, like when you click the mouse wheel, you might accidentally click this thing and then you change the program and then you might mess things up. So I actually locked it when I'm in game, you know. The scroll wheel feels nice, but it's a little bit hard to like click on the scroll mouse, on the scroll wheel, but the scrolling is, I really like it. It's like accurate and pretty exact. It's pretty nice. I like it a lot. Big scroll wheel, but very nice. All right, what do we have more? Yes, the cable here. This braided cable, goddamn it, it's awful. When you like, the friction of it is too much. So it might get stuck on the edge of your desk, and like the factory like folds, you can see, they are still basically intact. They never go out of the cable, so it has a weird shape. So I would actually prefer a rubber cable and not a braided cable. Now this thing, it looks a little bit like Ross, but it's some kind of grip thing, and I would probably like it if it was, more space for like your fingers here would be nice. Yeah, well, wondering if that is indeed enough information about this thing. I'd say that this mouse is not your best FPS mouse. Oh yes, it's heavy. This mouse is heavy. That's one of my big issues with it. When you slide it around here and you need to lift it up, it's hard to get the grip on the mouse. Because if you press too hard, you press a lot of random buttons. And if you press too little, you just drop it. And this edge here is not very nice to like touch. It's like thin plastic, almost. Yeah, you kind of get stuck there. It's weird. Oops. This mouse is heavy. It's not good if you're doing things where you want to lift it and drag it like this. If you can have it on pretty high sensitivity, it's very accurate. It's very, very accurate. So if you have like good surface, good control, and you don't need to lift it all the time, then it's good. If you're a person that lifts the mouse when you use it, I would not recommend this mouse. And I do that when I play FPS games, so I would not recommend it for FPS games. But for more like strategy chilled-out games where you need to have good and fast control for a lot of buttons on the thumb, this is a very good, high-quality mouse. But go to a store and actually check the proper size of the mouse so that you know it fits your hand. Because if it doesn't fit your hand exactly, it will not be a nice mouse to use. You will probably not be able to get used to it completely. So that's one thing to keep in mind. And basically, that's probably what I can say about this mouse. Buy it or not, it's your choice. But now you have heard my little review of it after 2 years of use. Thanks a lot for watching this video. And if you liked it, please leave a like and do subscribe for future videos. This is your host, Jim Resen, signing out.